not going to say, yeah, I don't have anything prepared.
Community and invest time in the community. People who organize that, people who like volunteer to help, they invest their lifetime. Risk would imply that something will fail, but life is a failure until you have success. Risk, there's always a risk. When I travel with a train, there's a risk. Or with a plane, there is a risk. My job is to like calculate risk, to avoid risk, to like make sure that risk can be avoided. Then it's a normal thing. So that's why for me, this question
no
is
biggest risk.
Yeah, there is no biggest risk. Whole bunch of things to it, and yeah, that would be the not answering your question.
To make my business as a full-time business. As a mom of kids, I'm not married. I was divorced some years ago, so I have to take care about health issue, insurance, social insurance, regularly income. You have to fill the fridge, take care of your kids. The decision to make my business in a full-time business, self-employed, was the biggest risk. I feel good with my decision now, after I managed to overcome the fear, collect a lot of information. But it's something I'm proud of, but I know I was really, really scared over years. I took this thought to make my business to a self-employed business a long time ago. I did it as a side job before, but the risk to make it the main income stream was really, really scary.
When I recently became a release lead for a major release, for minor release, 4.9.3. I was mostly familiar with how things should work, but I have never led a release. It was a new experience for me. I think that was the biggest risk. I think it went okay. Some things could be more smooth, but of been co-leading a couple of more minor releases since then, I had some progress on that. Becoming a release lead was a biggest risk.
No limit sport person. She would do all these, like, you know, she went to the Himalaya. She, you know, I was, when I started my work camp tour, I was like, okay, this is gonna be expensive and I'm not gonna be able to do this. Yoast has a diversity fund for minorities. And when my talk in Belfast got accepted, I was like, okay, can't afford to go there. It's really expensive. It's, you know, this is all piling up. And so I said, okay, maybe I can ask them. They say no, they're gonna say no, but maybe they're gonna say yes. People actually tend to say yes more often than no.